there has been no test because there is no use practicing something you cannot miss. This is what you call a one-shot deal, and I'm not coming back for any late show, honey. I'm going to do it one time.
Live fast, die young, and be a good-looking corpse.
Live fast, die young, and be a good-looking corpse. Right. Well, it depends on how you look at life after death. If a guy thinks his soul transfers to the beyond in the same form and shape that he might be when he dies, who the hell would want to live to be 90? Always admired the Jewish people for the business sense.
Yeah. yourself a cheap plate. You gotta get yourself a cheap pair of plastic sunglasses, a really cheap pair of plastic wrap rats. You can get them just down the street. It's $4 for the pair. You should stock up. You should buy 3 or 4 pairs. Really, no one ever fucks with you. You put them on. No one fucks with you. And they're cheap. It's better than a... better than a wig. Or a really stupid haircut. Or a nose ring. You get afraid on the bus, and you ever get... scared on the bus. Or the subway, you ever get frightened?
Thank you. You. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Freak me. Freak me. Freak me.
Skin. Be a documentary, but it'd be like sort of a time life thing. Different ways of brain modification. It'd be the computer simulating all different ways of feeling when you're on like different drugs,
different kinds of meditation, sex, anything, man. Think of it. It'd be like, have you read Understanding Comics?
Ever read what?
That book, Understanding Comics?
No.
You should read it. It's really good. I'll lend it to you if you need a copy.
Okay.
I don't know. I was spinning off thoughts. And the other thing I want to ask you about, you originally, when I met you, you weren't smoking dope because you used to get the fear, right?
Yeah.
Can you tell me about it?
The fear? I don't know, it's a hard thing to describe. It's
like it's just overwhelming and you just can't get control?
Yeah, well, that's like, it's like, yeah, it's overwhelming anxiety, right? And it's like...
And you can't combat it?
Yeah, and the thing is, for me, I think it's real personal for everyone, like, what level it takes. For me, it always takes this thing, like, it's always a control thing, like, having a control. Because really, I guess it's just an intensity, right? You know, it's just, like, unfamiliar intensity, right? You know, which is why I had to quit pot, because, you know, you're getting high and you just want to feel the same way you always do, and all of a sudden you're smoking joint, and it's this, you know what I mean, this whole, so it's an uncontrolled intensity thing, and then, like, I don't know, yeah, it's just, like, your body goes into, gets pumped full of adrenaline, right, and your heart starts going ka-chunk, ka-chunk.
Well, I'll tell you something, here's a good thought, this has happened to me 3 times recently, it never used to happen to me, I never ever feel, like, sick or anything, but it's like, you know, like, so what you're talking about, I'll be sitting there, I'll be wild, you know, because I don't smoke that much, maybe it's, like, once a week, you know, so trying to think something to build up your tolerance again.
Yeah.
And then I'll smoke and I'll be sitting there and I'll be like, you know, wow, I'm really high. All of a sudden I'll sort of slip into it, you know, and I'll be like, but I'm able to fight it. Like, a night on mushrooms I told you, but I just couldn't fight it. I surrendered myself to this mind fuck.
Yeah.
But, you know, when I'm on pot, it's like I feel strong enough. So I go, no, fuck it. I go, like, so I try to force myself to see it in a different way. I try to see it as, I don't get this high that often. So it's like a whole new way of seeing the world. So fuck, I might as well dig it, you know, instead of being afraid of it, and like, it works.
Yeah.
And it's like, yeah, this happened to me 3 times. It happened to me tonight again, you know. That's why I just walk around. I want to get an ice cream. I saw my sister's friend.
Thank you. plug it in. I jam through my TV. Electric cord fucked, mixed squiggles and lines. Sometimes so good and often a distort. Almost get high. Always out of phase, relayed by the curve at jacking on reverb or peeling off skin. A toast to the guts of it, and hammer on hard. Ratchet guitars, yeah, hammer on hard. Don't destroy my brain down, hey, maybe pause the future. Turn out the retard says all the cripples can party. Foreign pine saw on the speaker phone, bring on the shine. The white out the shine as I explode now. All lights sparked on a hairy amp drew and the hack and the rattle and the hairy gut shine. For the girls kissing girls and the boys kissing boys and the girls kissing boys, the hairy gut shine.
Preoccupied with hoarding. Ooh. Till you go to the grave. Captain Angel's falling. Laughing at the holes in me. Kissing through the chip window. Fuck this.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to write out your history that easily. I love you. I'm glad you're okay. Have you talked to Father John?
No, no, I haven't been in there. So, you know, a couple months.
No, I'm still around. Do you need anything?
No, no. Yep.
Thank you. Dress like shit, we don't need it, we go to sleep.